إن لله عبادا فطنا طلقوا الدنيا وخافوا الفتنا نظروا فيها فلما علموا أنها ليست لحي وطنا
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير وضع الحجة وأتم المحجة ويأبى الله إلا أن يتم نوره ولو كره الكافرون ونشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح للأمة فكشف الله عز وجل به الغمة وجاهد في الله حق الجهاد حتى آتاه اليقين فاللهم اجزه عنا خير ما جزيت به نبيا عن أمته ورسولا عن دعوته ورسالته وصل يا ربنا على صحابته الغر الميامين أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وباقي صحابة نبيك أجمعين ومن سار على هديهم واقتفى أثرهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين ثم أما بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما صدق الله العظيم وبلغ رسوله الكريم ونحن على ذلك من الشاهدين Dear respected brothers and sisters, all praise are for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The one we are seeking is assistance, his forgiveness. And the one we are seeking the refuge in him subhanahu wa ta'ala from the evils of our souls and the wickedness of our deeds. Whomever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides shall never go astray. And whomever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allows to go astray shall never find guidance. And we as the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the beloved prophet to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the leader, the teacher, we as the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we bear witness with dignity and pride that there is no God but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his last messenger. May the blessing and the peace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be upon him, upon his family, upon his wives, upon his companions, and upon you, the followers of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, with piety till the day of judgment. Dear respected brothers and sisters, Muhammad alayhi salatu wa salam has never left anything taking us closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Jannah without guiding his ummah too. He has never left anything that will take this ummah away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's pleasure, Jannah, and did get them closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's anger and the hellfire. without warning his ummah from. Alayhi salatu wassalam, the most merciful of his ummah, as he will be saying in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in that great day, the day that there is no one will have a single word of all prophets from Adam till Isa alayhi salam, till Jesus, except to Muhammad. Everyone cannot speak even a word before Allah on the day that Allah will be angry in a way that he has never and will never be as such. And everyone is appointing his finger to one person, talking to the whole humanity, telling them, we could do nothing. We cannot speak up on this day. Only one man. Go to Muhammad. And everyone will go to Muhammad. Muhammad, it's 50,000 years just standing and few millimeters between your head and the sun. We cannot bear it at a time. It's 83 million light years apart. And it will be few millimeters from the heads. 50,000 years without starting the accountability yet. Everyone is waiting for Allah's permission to start. And everyone will go to Muhammad. Muhammad, you are the one who can intercede. The first part of his intercession. And the Prophet will say, "Ana laha." I can take care of it. And he will go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, prostrate in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala throne. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will open on his tongues, praising Allah in a way that no one did before Muhammad. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will tell Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam, "Muhammad, irfa' ra'sak, raise your head. Was'al tu'ta, just ask, you will be given. Washfa' tushaffa', intercede, and you are granted." And the first he will say, "I am begging you on that great day, the ummah of Muhammad. Love Muhammad the way he loves you." That's it. Worry about his sunnah and his deen. I'm not gonna say similar. Half of what Muhammad is worrying about you and your deen. Worry about your family and your kids. Half of what Muhammad is worrying about you and your kids. Protect yourself from the hellfire, half the way that Muhammad is protecting you from the hellfire. And he will say to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, before nothing, before saying my family, "Ya Rabbu Ummati, Ya Rabbu Ummati, Ya Allah my Ummah, my Ummah, my Ummah." The Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We have been seeing a lot of stuff that's considered as a result of the weakness of fearing Allah. And today's subject is one of the fruits, the positive fruits of fearing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have been begging, we have been pushing, fear Allah. As the three verses that Muhammad used to start with his companions in every lecture, switching the button of fearing Allah. Fear Allah the way it should be feared. And die not but in the state of Islam. Always the call is, oh human being, oh who believe, fear Allah. Once that fear is acting upon inside the heart, because the fear is not an external, it's not an external sense. It's not an external act. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, qala at-taqwa hahuna. The fearing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is in. It will be worked out inside. It will be boiling up inside. Then the fruits will come to make the senses, hands, eyes, ears, tongues, private parts, legs, working upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's deen and direction. Today's session is one out of tens of flowers in tens of gardens that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam left to this ummah. To keep picking up every day, that will never take you to nowhere but closer to Allah and closer to Jannah. and nowhere but further away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's anger and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's hellfire. Muhammad alayhi salatu wa salam did say, we have been asking about what the hell is going on with those crazy diseases that we have never heard of. All generation have never heard of H1N1, HIV, what's going on? And others and others and others, from the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's punishment to the human being when they are violating the rules of Allah and breaking the borders. Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam did say in one of the hadith, ma dhaharat al-fahisha, when the fahisha, adultery, pornos, fornication, illegality, unlawful things will appear. It used to be at every era, but even the criminals used to commit, but they are still thinking they are doing something wrong, so they are hiding, disappearing. We have reached the time that right has become wrong and wrong has become right. If you don't have a girlfriend, you are psychologically sick and you need to be subjected to a psychiatric, which is happening in the West. If you are not eating pork, you have something wrong. It doesn't work out. And that's what Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did say. We have come to the time that the illegality has become open, no shyness. Those who have been living in the West, or even coming into some parts, we have been dividing East and West, and in reality, to some extent, sometimes we might not see that big difference. The whole issue is, you don't know exactly where you are. You are in some areas in what's called the East, and you are worse than 52 Street in New York. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam did say, when the illegality, that violation to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's rules, will become that open and public. When they used to disappear, they still have something we are worrying about. Forget about rules, forget about laws. We are worrying about the shyness and the worrying about breaking the borders. And I'm not talking about others. I'm talking about Muslims. Let's make it clear, because some others, they have no rules, no borders. They are not worrying about nothing. Their God is the nature. Their God is nothing. I'm talking about the Ummah of Muhammad. The Ummah of Muhammad, who are gonna commit, and the next day I'm gonna go to do Umrah, just to clean up and come back to do again and go and clean up. And what's going on? What's going on? You know that there is Allah? Yes. There is the Day of Judgment? Yes. There is Allah's books? Yes. There is Allah's angels? Yes. There is Allah's destiny, good and bad? Yes. There is Allah's prophets? Yes. He fulfilled all the requirement of faith. But then, we don't have what we are going to talk about. We don't have iffah. We don't have afaf. We don't have chastity. We don't have one of the fruits of the taqwa. So the base is cracked, and the products of that base is also cracked. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, if the time will come and it will be open, like TVs, satellites, streets, malls, beaches, nightclubs, it's open. Nothing is just, no one is hiding. It's just, illa asabahumullahu بالأوجاع والطواعين التي لم تكن في أسلافهم. It's Allah's grant that that community, that generation, Allah will infect them with diseases, cancers, bloods, that it has never come to the previous generations. صدق صلى الله عليه وسلم. صدق صلى الله عليه وسلم. Chastity, the Ummah of Muhammad, is one of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's great attributes and morals given to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to establish in this ummah. And it's enough to know that, you know, one of the grants of Jannah, you are going to Hajj and coming back. Those who did go and they came back and they are not sure what's going on, whether Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did accept or not. They said, لبيك اللهم لبيك, and they are not sure, did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reply back, لبيك وسعديك, you are also accepted and here is the happiness, or no لبيك no سعديك. Some will go and come back with nothing except spending the money and some effort on the flights back and forth. Because there is no change. Hearts have never boiled for the great journey with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to refresh the tawheed, to refresh the seeds of piety. Allah has given us through the chastity a grant of Jannah. As Muhammad alayhi salatu wa salam did say, three whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is granting them, three categories Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are making them go into Jannah the first. And one of those three categories, Afif Mutaafif. And just forgive me, wanna make sure that we get the meaning behind the Arabic words. Afif is the one who will stop the haram when the halal and haram are offered. Mutaafif, it's another further step when you are going into the halal and you started to get some doubtful issues, mushtabahat. It might be, maybe wrong, maybe right. And the mutaafif, who is even taking a decision, why should go into something that can be risky? Why should go into this? If it's no, what I'm gonna say to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the day of judgment? Just like the whole salary, 10 dirhams halal and 2 dirhams haram. It's okay, I'm gonna eat from all. Why have to get into that mess? I don't need that too. I don't need the issues that's doubtful. I'm just giving examples. You are buying the medicine and you are seeing a part of the ingredient gelatin. And you ask the pharmacist, is it a kosher? Is it a pork? Is it a beef? And he said, I don't know. We don't have the information. Oh, what's wrong? Maybe. Let me deal with it. You can, but that's not mutaafif. What I have to deal with? The one who is given the recovery is Allah. The one who is given the healing is Allah. The one who is harming and benefiting is Allah. You are dealing with the medicine as a tool. So why? If I don't know what the case, and it can be a risk, even 0.5%, that it can be risky, and it can be a part of Allah's haram that I'm dealing with, I don't need it. That's mutaafif. The Sahaba of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to have, this time if we are gonna divide the dunya into 10 parts, we have 9 parts, 9.9 parts haram and 1.1 part halal, and we are dealing with the 10. The Sahaba of Muhammad used to have the 10 parts, just an example, math. The 10 parts, 9.9 out of them is halal and 0.1 is haram. And they used to avoid the whole package, worrying about the 0.1 haram that they might get in. If the whole package, I should get that 0.1 in, I don't need it. And that's mutaafif. And it's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's grant to that category to be the first who will make it to Jannah behind Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that is the reason the Prophet alayhi salatu wa salam used to leave to this ummah one of his great du'as, supplication. Allahumma inni as'aluka at-tuqa wal-huda wal-afafa wal-ghina. Starting with the way, getting into the base, then the fruits. Into the same du'a. Ya Allah, I ask you to be guided the way. Wat-tuqa, the base, to fear you, Ya Allah. And if the two are correct, what about the fruits? Without Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's tawfiq and support, you might not get it. Wal-afafa, the chastity, the wara'. I don't need whatever can have even a little risk. I don't need it, Ya Allah. I don't need it. Wal-ghina, to be at a position that I need no one but you. I'm not gonna stick to the faith into the doctor, the faith into my job, the faith into the power. All could be gone except Allah.
So Allah, the ghina is not the richness in money. The ghina in your heart is to feel that you are the richest if Allah is with you, even you don't have a filth in your pocket for 10 years. Because the one who has the treasures of earth and heavens is with you. Inna Allah ma'ana. I have Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with me. You are not worrying about nothing. Because the reach can be nothing between a blinking of an eye. بين عشية وضحى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the chapter of Rahman, كل يوم هو في شأن. Every day he has a separate matter. You don't know what's going to happen. The only thing that's stable, ويبقى وجه ربك ذو الجلال والإكرام. The only sustainable thing is the ma'iyyah, is to be with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Out of the chastity that we would like to hopefully to get a part of in today's Jum'ah, to leave the masjid, and we are worrying, we want to start stopping. We are not saying we want to start suppressing our life. No. We want to start stopping at every event, every single word, every action. As the Sahaba did learn from Muhammad, is it halal or haram? Then move forward. Is it pure halal or doubtful? Then move forward. That is the way the Sahaba got what they got from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's it. Abu Bakr, when he heard one day that a part of the milk he did drink maybe a month ago was just mixed with some money that has come from gambling or bingo. He told his servant, are you crazy? The milk that I got inside my stomach? And he had thrown himself up a month ago. Why I have to keep in my... It's already gone, ya Abu Bakr. And wallahi, you didn't know. And wallahi, you are good. And wallahi, you are in Jannah. And wallahi, you are the best to Allah of the human being after the prophets. But that's afaf and iffa. Why I should get into either even an issue which might be little that can spoil my whole life, dunya and akhirah? The top out of the chastity that we need to achieve or to get a trigger of and leave the masjid inshaAllah thinking about is the chastity of the senses. As the product of the piety that will keep boiling inside your heart. Fear Allah, worry about Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching you. Fear Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching you. Then, Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam is telling this ummah, you want to make it to Jannah? Little issues. But it needs some work. It needs some homework to be taken care of. Man damina li, whomever is going to grant me the chastity, the piety of his tongue and his private part. Too little. We have not talked yet about ears. We have not talked yet about tens of others. Just one small example from the hadith of Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. He's saying, if you will be able to grant the chastity of your tongue and your private part, you are granted Jannah. The tongue, Abu Bakr, the great man, is holding his tongue saying, you are the one who will take me to the hellfire. Abu Bakr. Radiallahu anhu wa arda. And the private part. We have come to a time haram has become so easy and the ummah has made the halal difficult as well. The completely opposite way. Halal has become tough, not that easy, not accessible, means, tools, dowry, expenses, some toughness from the parents, issues here, issues there, no deen, and haram has become simple. Even via internet and Skype and Facebooks. Adultery. The ummah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will hold them accountable for every blinking of their eye. Inna as-sam'a wal-basara wal-fu'ad. Your eyes, your sight, your hearing, your heart. Kullu ulaika kana anhu mas'oola. Everything you will be held accountable for. even a blinking of your eye. Before you look at, Allah knows what you want to think of. يَعْلَمُ خَائِنَةَ الْأَعْيُنِ وَمَا تُخْفِ الصُّدُورِ. The tongue. How many incidents that we know that the tongue did break families because of a word? A false word has been transferred between families. That was the reason for a man to divorce his righteous wife forever. And it has ended up with the spoiling and the loss of the whole kids because of a word. How many will make it to the hellfire, as Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam did say, because of one word that can put the one who did say either 70 years in Jannah or 7 years down in the hellfire. إِنَّ الْعَبْدَ لَيَقْذِفُ بِالْكَلِمَةِ. The servant might say the word and he's not paying an attention to. It can put him in Jannah for 7 years or dip him down in the hellfire for 7 years. A word. A word. If you are joking with some of your friends, telling him you are kafir. A word. One of you is kafir. Make the decision. The Prophet saying, whomever is going to play with those words, one. Oh, you are kafir. And he's not. And the Prophet said, one of the two should be. If it's not the one you have directed the word to, then you are. How many times you try out of anger of the shaitan deviation, or you told your wife you are divorced for the fourth and fifth and sixth and time, and your whole life with her is haram. A word, talik, divorced. A word. A word. Aisha one day, out of the jealousy of the wives, and they are the great wives, the great mothers of believers, but jealousy, jealousy, human being. And she said to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, why you, just like you are talking about Safiya, Safiya is just short, just short. That's it. And the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, we used to see him from his anger in his face. He told her, Aisha, As-Siddiqa bint As-Siddiq, the great woman, the daughter of the great man. And the wife of Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. He told her, that little word that you said, Wallahi, if it will be mixed with the whole potable water on the earth, it will convert it into seas and oceans. Short. How many out of those who are directing to one another, oh, see how he's just like skinny, just like he's too fat, and he's too ugly, he's too, and he's too, and he is too. How many? A word. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did say in the Quran, مَا يَلْفِظُ مِنْ قَوْلٍ إِلَّا لَدَيْهِ رَقِيبٌ عَتِيدٌ. There is no single word without having the two monitors, and it should be written. The one who will make it into the book of your verses or the book of your wickednesses. Simple. Simple. And it's a word. The truthfulness and lying. You can keep saying the truth till you will be written. That's the chastity of your tongue. You are worrying about even playing with the word to deceive the guy who's in front of you. And the Prophet saying, the worst, the largest treachery to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to talk to your brother and he has the confidence that you are truthful and you are lying. You know somebody, you have the trust with one another, and you kept telling him, and the guy is so open, so transparent, because he likes you. He trusted you, and you are feeding, and he is fully, without doubt, believing in every word you are saying, and you are lying. That's the largest level of treachery in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You are going to keep saying the truth till you will be written in the book of Allah as Siddiq. And you will keep playing and saying the lie till you will be written in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Kadhab. Liar. The tongue. The eye. How many times you are breaking the rules? And inshallah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if we'll have time, give me 10 minutes just after the khutbah to make sure for those who have commitments can leave peacefully. I want to make sure that this particular, we need to get a little injection of how we can achieve the chastity. Because we are playing, some of the human beings are dealing with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because they are fearing Allah, regardless what will be the reward and what will be the punishment, which is called the business of the free. Abu Bakr, he's not worrying about Jannah, he's not worrying about Nar. He's worrying about Allah's pleasure. He's not making a deal. Some of the Sahaba, they need Jannah. Some of the Sahaba there, some people, one of your kids, you know his key is to give him an incentive. One of your employees, his key is to give him an incentive. If you will finish this report tomorrow morning, you will be promoted. And another guy next to him, if you will not finish this report tomorrow morning, you are terminated. Each one of them has a different key. Each one of them has a different key. And some of the human beings, you need to tell them how worse and how it will come back to their own families for not applying the chastity of their eyes and their tongue. I'm gonna just leave the principle, then we can elaborate on after the salah. Nothing will be lost. Nothing. You looked at somebody with haram, it's a grant. It should come back to either your daughter, your mother, your sister, your wife. It's a system. What we used to call in math and in Islam, it's a closed loop. Do it the way you like. اِفْعَلْ مَا شِئْتْ كَمَا تَدِينُ تُدَانُ. The way it's gonna be paid, it will be paid back. Simple. And Imam Shafi'i is given, stealing the guys, don't play with the chastity of your senses. If you will commit adultery out of your house with money, it will come back to your house with no money. It will come back to your house with no money. من زنى في بيته بغير الدرهم بالدرهم زني في بيته بغير الدرهم. Allah will send it back as a punishment. The private parts. The zina of al-ayn, the zina of the ears, the zina of the tongue, they are committing adultery? Yes. As Muhammad did say, al-aynayani tazniyan wa zinahuma an-nadhar. The eyes are committing adultery, and their zina is to look at the haram. وَاللِّسَانُ يَزْنِي وَزِنَاهُ النُّطْقُ. And the tongue is committing adultery by saying what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made it haram. The ears will commit adultery by listening what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made it haram. وَالْقَدَمَانِ. The legs, the feet will commit adultery to walk to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made haram. And the bottom line, all those are called adultery, but with no punishment in dunya. The only punishment in dunya is the adultery with the private part. وَيُصَدِّقْ عَلَى ذَٰلِكَ كُلُّهُ أَوْ يُكَذِّبُهُ زِنَ الْفَرْجِ. To get into the had, to the punishment in the Islamic court, it should be the other one. It should be the one with the private part. But all whatever, as introduction, is called adultery. And it will be paid back at the same level. At the same level. From the chastity that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has given it to this ummah. Acquiring money, earning, getting money with no right. Taking the money of others without. Some people are, we are talking about, some are worrying about a filth, and some are eating acres, and they have no problem. They are not worrying. And I'm gonna leave also one trigger so we can keep thinking of. We're talking about the chastity of acquiring money, earning, gaining, dealing with trusts that I have in my hand. Somebody gave you 100 dirhams to keep with you as a trust. Are you gonna keep it, or you are gonna try to play the game and take apart from here? And subhanallah, brother, we don't have a piece of paper and it's lost. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam is saying, daniq. Keep remembering that word in Arabic. Daniq. That daniq, with the currency of the time of Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam, converted to nowadays currency, it's one fifth of the fils, not the dirham. One fifth of a fils. And the Prophet saying, Danik haram, one fifth of a fils haram, is eating up, spoiling the reward of 600 salah accepted obligatory. One fifth of a fils, 600 salah of the obligation and accepted. We are not aware of how we are accepted. Accepted, one fifth of a fils. That means 10 dirhams can take care of the whole of the hell deeds in the whole life. Haram. Is it worthy? أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم فاستغفروا من كل ذنب إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. استغفرك ربنا كل ذنب وخطيئة وتوب إليه. استغفرك ربنا كل ذنب وخطيئة وتوب إليه. استغفرك ربنا كل ذنب وخطيئة وتوب إليه. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. From the chastity learned from Muhammad عليه الصلاة والسلام is to ask for no need. Those who are making the begging as a profession, and we have been seeing it has become like gangs, and we hear in the news stuff that Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam has received in the Quran the criteria for those who are worthy in need. Those who are worthy in need, you will never see them begging money. تحسبهم أغنياء من التعفف لا يسألون الناس إلحافا. You will think that they are so rich because of the way they are acting. Brother, are you in need? والله يا أخي سبحان الله. والله الله سبحانه وتعالى has given me a lot. And والله العظيم, this guy has no enough for his lunch and dinner of the same day. But he has the tranquility and faith in his heart. And he will say, please find somebody else. I'm sure there is somebody else has more need. We have reached that level during the era that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made this ummah successful. The zakah used to go from the far east to the far west. And for sure the ummah has some poor people. And it's coming back to Medina. And no one is taking zakah. Everyone is, his door is knocked, he's saying, Alhamdulillah, wallahi, Allah has given me a lot. And if you will, in reality, open his door, you will see nothing except the very little. And he's really in need. But he has al-ghina. He has the need to no one but Allah. Those who have been making it as a profession, those who are gonna come, I want to make sure that everyone did understand that little message. If you are going to make up the poverty, make it up, I can grant you that you will be poor. Because that's Allah's grant. Allah has given you a lot. Somebody has come to ask for a loan or something to support him. And he is deserving to be supported. And you are going to make up being poor. Wallahi, brother, you don't know exactly what's happening to me. It's too tough those days. You know the economic crisis. And he can see by the door 6 Range Rovers and 3 Porsche and 2 Lamborghini. And you're telling me just, it's too tough those days. And the guy's asking about 1,000 dirhams. Or you have made up the poverty. The Prophet's saying, it's granted that Allah will make you poor. Because he did not confirm Allah's bounty on you. وَأَمَّا بِنِعْمَةِ رَبِّكَ فَحَدِّثْ. If somebody told you, how are you, brother? You don't need to say about numbers. You don't need to say that I have in Islam, Dubai Islamic Bank, I have $3 billion. You don't need to say that. But you need to say, Alhamdulillah, Allah has given me enough. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed me with a lot. But just, brother, just. 50-50. Wishy-washy. Okey-dokey. What the hell is going on? For what? For what? That's not the dunya. That's not the dunya. Let's listen to the end up, inshallah, with the hadith of Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told Muhammad to tell this ummah, if you have been granted 4 attributes from Allah, you should not worry about anything else that you missed in this dunya. إِذَا جَاءَكَ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا أَرْبَعَ. If you will get out in this dunya, 4 issues. وَاللَّهِ الْعَظِيمِ, you missed nothing in this dunya. Missed nothing, nothing. حِفْظُ أَمَانَة. To be blessed by Allah, to be honest. وَصِدْقُ حَدِيثِ. To be blessed by Allah, to be truthful. وَحُسْنُ خَلِيقَةٍ. To be blessed by Allah, to have original shape. Nothing is odd. وَعِفَّةٌ فِي طُعْمَةٍ. And to be blessed by Allah for your food and whatever you are eating, earning, to be from halal. If you have those 4, وَاللَّهِ الْعَظِيمِ, you missed nothing out of this dunya. As Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam did say. You know what the last one can grant you? To be purified in your rizq. You know what's granted? What the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam told Sa'd ibn Abi Waqas? Ya Sa'd, atib mat'amak, takum mustajab al-da'wah. Purify your rizq, purify what you are eating. You're raising your hands with the dua is granted the acceptance. And that's the reason the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam did mention about the guy who has been just like scattering his hair and making himself looking like tired out of the ibadah, praying the whole night. And the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam told them, رُبَّ أَشْعَثْ أَغْبَرْ. It might be a guy, he looks like tired out of the too much of ibadah, too much of the acts of worship, but his food is from haram. His drink is from haram. His dress is from haram. يَدْعُ اللَّهَ. He's gonna make dua to Allah. And the Prophet saying, how he thinks that Allah can accept? أَنَّ يُسْتَجَابُ لَهُ. How Allah can accept? Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave it as a gift to Sa'd ibn Abi Waqas and the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You wanna be of accepted dua? It doesn't matter how much. It does matter how quality is it, even if it's less. Purify your rizq, your dua is accepted. I know somebody to show me the wife who used to tell her husband before going to his office in the morning, stop man, stop. Please, I wanna give you an advice before going to earn your rizq. Instead of giving him the list of what to have to buy from Dubai Mall. Stop. See, we can be patient on hunger and poverty, but we cannot be patient on the hell and the hellfire. Please, fear Allah in what you are earning and bringing to our family. Where is this wife? Can you tell me where is it? Is it there? If yes, put her in a box as a pearl, because you have a piece of al-Jannah. If you have such wife, if you have such sister, if you have such mother, if you have such daughter, that is the one who learned it from Aisha and learned from Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide the ummah back to the right path, the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the sunnah of Muhammad. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fill our hearts with His love and the love of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala return the ummah back to the dignity and the glory that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has granted Muhammad and his companions. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect all of us from the hellfire. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless each one of us with the chastity in his heart, in his senses. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Grant us the guidance, the piety, the chastity, and al-ghina, as Muhammad alayhi salatu wa salam did say, to need no one but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahumma inna nas'aluka al-tuqa wal-huda wal-afafa wal-ghina. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make all of us among those who are going to be able to make it on their deathbed, and their last statement is la ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect the whole ummah from the fitan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala return the ummah back to the book of Allah and the sunnah of Muhammad. Ya akram al-akramin, ya arham al-rahimin, la taj'al lana fi hadha al-yawm al-azim dhanban illa ghafartah, wala maridan illa shafaytah, wala asiran illa yassartah, wala karban illa farrajtah, wala hamman illa adhabtah, wala sadran dayiqan illa sharahtah, wala ma'suran fi sabilika illa fakakta asrah, wala aduwan illa qasamtah, wala aduwan illa qasamtah, wala aduwan illa qasamtah, wala taliban mujtahidan lidinika illa najjahtah. ولا حاجة من حوائج الدنيا لك فيها رضا ولنا فيها صلاح إلا وقضيتها لنا يا رب العالمين. اللهم ارفع مقتك وغضبك عنا. ربنا لا تؤاخذنا بما فعل السفهاء منا. ربنا لا تسلط علينا بذنوبنا من لا يخافك ولا يخشاك ولا يرحمنا. اللهم ولي أمورنا خيارنا ولا تولي أمورنا شرارنا. واختم يا ربنا بالباقيات الصالحات أعمالنا. اللهم فرح بنا قلب نبينا. اللهم فرح بنا قلب نبينا. اللهم فرح بنا قلب نبينا. اللهم إن أردت بعبادك فتنة فاقبضنا إليك مسلمين مؤمنين غير مفتونين ولا فاتنين ولا خزايا ولا نادمين ولا مبدلين. اللهم رد الأمة إلى دينك ردا جميلا حسنا. اللهم ردنا إلى كتابك ردا جميلا حسنا. اللهم ردنا إلى سنة نبيك ردا جميلا حسنا. اقسم لنا من خشيتك ما تحول به بيننا وبين معاصيك، ومن طاعتك ما تبلغنا به جنتك، ومن اليقين ما تهون به علينا مصائب الدنيا. ومتعنا اللهم بأسماعنا وأبصارنا وقوتنا ما أحييتنا، واجعله الوارث منا، واجعل ثأرنا على من ظلمنا، ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا، ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا، ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا، ولا تجعل الدنيا هي أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا، ولا إلى النار مصيرنا. صل يا ربنا على حبيبنا محمد في الأولين، وصلي عليه في الآخرين، وصلي عليه في الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين، وصلي عليه يا ربنا في كل وقت وحين. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. وأقم الصلاة.